energy.
Hey guys, I'm Nick Meister, and welcome back to Let's Play Hitman Absolution. And the next stop on our journey is Birdie's gift? What? What could that guy possibly give us, huh? Mobile Command Center. Now, I gotta say, this is an awful lot bigger than I pictured, the agency being. I always thought it was very secretive and small.
Sir, I think you need to see this.
It's quite a tattoo.
Sir, you really need to see this.
Why?
What?
Can't you see I'm smoking
it's a
here?
Gift. From an
smoking
old
inside.
It's been off the grid for a couple of years now. Codename Birdie.
We codenamed the guy Birdie. No wonder he went off the grid.
Did they name him that and then he got into birds? Or was he into birds and that's why they named him that? It's weird. Okay. What is this guy in a fucking hazmat suit? What?
47. I'll be damned.
You're not really that surprised, are you?
Give the birdman what he wants. You find 47 at any cost.
At any cost. Even $1 billion. And she's smirking because she's gonna embezzle all that cash. That's gross. Look at all those fucking feathers. And he drew a bird taking a shit. That's great. That's really classy, Birdie. Ugh. Yeah, if I sound a little more irritable than normal, it's because it's about 98 degrees in Boston right now, and my room that I'm recording this in doesn't have any air conditioning, and I turned off the fan so it wouldn't interrupt my... Huh. Those things look kind of familiar. Let's take a closer look. Oh, yeah, there they are. Mmm. I can just taste it. What?
They're mine.
Yeah, you tell them.
Not unless you got a receipt.
Oh, look at Grandpa Vader over here trying to be a tough guy. Him. Yeah, I could just take him. I'll kill your ass.
You don't look much like a thief.
It wouldn't be stealing.
Mm-hmm. Ugh. You need a scarf or something.
On the girl.
What? Is that laughing?
Any of me ain't got shit on my sweet Lily. Let's see what you got.
Was that guy laughing? Was that what that was supposed to be? Or something? I don't know. Oh, look at that smug bastard walking off. We shouldn't have to outshoot anyone. These are our fucking guns.
Hey, how's it hanging, huh?
Oh, leave me alone, you fucking jerk. So here they are. Hey, seems
man,
to be some paper or something lying under them, too.
I can't seem to find any shotgun ammo.
Should be stocking back.
Okay, so
ammo.
Before we get started, we gotta stock up on ammo, and we gotta listen to some silly conversations. So strap yourselves in. A metal pipe here.
Really? All of it? In one day?
Yeah. And... he's been cussing like a rabid dog all day, too.
Oh, really?
Dang, city folk got no manners.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, those city folks.
Hey, dang, hey, I do that. From, but every other
guy?
Word? Well, that's just childish and immature.
Well, that's how we do it in the big city douchebag, you fucking prick.
Making them real special.
Asshole.
That's not how people talk in real life.
Oh, my shoes.
That's the truth. So when in the hootenanny are you ever going to get stocked up on ammo again?
In a day or two, and that's true.
Okie dokie. I'll just till around a bit and see if I can find something special for the kids. Maybe a little pistol, like a 38.
And I guess...
All right. I guess
that last line is supposed to be, like a parody or a satire, but honestly, that's probably a conversation that's happened quite a few times in a gun shop. Alright, silly conversation number two.
There you go, baby. Aren't you beautiful now?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. Look at that shine. Huh. Oh, got something in my teeth. Yeah, you're gleaming, baby. Are you a hungry gun, huh? Is it time for daddy to load you?
Yeah, there's not too many things more beautiful than a relationship between a man and his sidearm. Yeah. Alright. Silly conversation number 3 coming up.
Help you, miss?
Hi.
Are you sure you want to talk to her? It kind of looks like she's from the big city.
Well, it's a gun
you wouldn't
shop,
want to sell a gun to a big city slicker now, would you? You know, we got to get that thing, but I'll leave that for later.
Can I try one?
Yeah, just
actually, I probably could have gotten it right now when his back was turned, but I wasn't really thinking about that. I was thinking about recording this this little conversation here. Oh, there's a nice Confederate hat. Fucking traitors. Be careful, toys are not guns. Yes, they are. They're the funnest guns. They're the funnest toys of all. At least I assume so. I've never actually fired a gun before, but it looks fun.
What about that big one?
That is a nice choice.
Yeah, those sure are some signs.
This is your Kazo TRG, developed for taking down big game a long distance with, might I add, superb precision.
You mentioned big game.
You know, that lady looks awfully familiar. Like, we've seen her somewhere before. Maybe in the Terminus Hotel?
That's very interesting. People considered big game?
What are you specifically interested in?
I'm gonna take a few laps around here while I'm waiting for these people to finish up.
Competition? Hunting?
I think this lady's supposed to be a different lady from the one in the hotel who's angry at her husband, but I like to pretend like it is her, and she's just looking to buy a gun.
Which species? I mean,
why would she come all the way to South Dakota to buy a gun to kill her husband in Chicago? I don't know, but that's what I like to believe.
Still sings.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Dead sure.
Okay, well then, why don't you take a good look around the shop? Maybe there's something a little more suited for your purpose. No point buying more gun than you need.
I suppose not. I think I'm gonna take a look around. I truly thank you for your help.
Well, if you have any other questions, just fire them on
over. Whoa.
I mean, just, you know, ask.
Yeah, don't give her any ideas, dude. Gotta be careful around that one. Alright, so, we gotta get our guns back, and, well, our key to all this, well, not to everything, but you'll see that later, is, oh, wait, where the fuck am I going? Oh, right, so, we want to get that guy away from the desk. Like I said before, I could have snuck around when he was dealing with that lady planning to murder her husband, but, well, this is another way. So, you break that fuse box. Gets a little dark in here, and he has to go back and figure it out. And, just making sure there's no one around the corner. I'm gonna pick up this key card here. There we go. And that's gonna let us into the bunker out back. Oh. Hey, there's a revolver with a pink, handle on it. Oh, makes me feel pretty. Alright. Let's get around here. You gotta be very careful not to let anyone on the shooting range see us, because if they see us, they'll start shooting at us, because, I don't know, maybe they think we're gonna steal some of the paper targets or something. I don't know. There we go. And there's some goodies inside here. There's this baby right here. Yeah, the Ultramax. Gonna fuck some shit up with that. And here is the combination to the safe we haven't even seen yet. And we could get that off of Mr. McGarmond himself, if I was feeling particularly murder-tastic. Huh, that's a lot of toilet paper. And a slop bucket, too. This is pretty fucking gross. Let's get out of here. Right. I think there's something else we can get. Let's go over here. Actually, we're gonna pick up a Kazo TRG, the gun that lady was eyeing back there. And, here's our would-be competition if we weren't just stealing the guns outright. I mean, not stealing. Taking back is what I mean. Okay, let's go back here. Now slow down, we don't want these people to see us. And, well, there's Mr. McGarmond. Like I said, we could kill him. We could push him off the balcony right here and then take the combination off his body, but... Oh, I kind of have a soft spot for Granddaddy Vader, you know? But, oh, hold on. Huh.
Stop staring at me, you twisted little...
It's Lynch! What? Lynch, I think those are gnomes, actually. I think that's the proper terminology for the... What? You're not gonna shoot the gnomes, are you?
Hey! Mr. Mason, what did I tell you about my gnomes? Stop it, okay? Keep your crazy ass out of here. I'll do it. You just watch.
Oh, buddy, I'd be really careful around this guy. He's fucking nuts. He's crazier than I am. Alright, so over here on the left is Mr. McGarmond's office, and the safe is in here. And inside the safe is the key to the display case that holds our precious silver ballers. Just making sure there's no one sneaking up on us. There we go. And we can just sneak right through this vent here. And no one will see us. Nice. Shooting ducks, huh?
Hey, you hear old Lenny's back?
Oh, shit. Been nice and quiet without that cowpie.
Yeah, but what can you do?
Put a shotgun up his ass and blow his brains out?
Or a goddamn bullhorn right up the crack of that boy's ass.
Yeah, but his gimpy ass probably like that.
Yeah, I can think of two more people that might like that, too. All right. Let's get out of here, all these hicks, all these hillbillies, let's just leave. And here they are. But you know, it's kind of unsatisfying. I mean, that was awfully short, you know? I kind of feel like I want to prove myself, you know, earn them back. After all I've been through. Oh, look at that smug bastard, I'll show you a thing or two. No girl's gonna outshoot me. Let's look at the scores first. Alright, Lily McGarmond is up on top. Okay, a lot of names here. Wait, hold on a second. Lenny Dexter and... What? Someone wrote Limp Dick. Limp Dick Lenny. Alright, let's talk to Lily McGarmond here.
Well, hey there, cowboy. I hear you're up for a match.
Yeah?
Go on ahead and pick out any gun you want from that store over here. Once you've picked out your piece, come on back and we'll rumble. But don't worry about ammo. As long as you're competing, you can use all you want.
Okay, and that wasn't awkward at all. Right, so... Here's the other way to get our guns back. The second option, the honest option, I guess. Hey, we got matching pistols. Alright. Now I feel just like Lily. So, here's an annoying part of the game, in my opinion. You want to aim for headshots, and you want to hit the red part of the target. And that gets you the most points. 20 points, that is. If you hit anything else, well, you're gonna lose. Because, Lily's score is awfully high. Now, when the game tells you you can use point shooting, you know multiple targets are coming up. So... Using the point shooting's pretty important to winning this stage, although I'm sure that there are plenty of people out there with videos getting a million points or whatever with no focus at all, but hey. I've got four targets here. For some reason they thought it was a good idea to have the NPCs saying something every single time you shot a target. So, one thing I'd like to mention is that, in the game, in the single-player campaign, that is, Lily Lily's last name is McGarmon, which makes sense. She's most likely the granddaughter of Granddaddy Vader over here. But in the contracts mode, where you can make your own contract, her name is actually Lily Dukes, like Dukes of Hazzard, I guess. It's kind of odd. It's kind of like that guy from the Terminus stage whose name is Joe, but they give him another name. And in case you haven't realized by now, I lose this round.
Not around a woman, but a gun.
Why don't you try again with a different gun?
And you know, Lily's nice about it though. She doesn't gloat, you know. But I think I'm gonna try a different gun, like she said. So I just shot that gnome, and we're gonna get poor Lynch in a little bit of trouble here.
What did I just tell you? To not shoot the goddamn gnome!
That wasn't exactly my fault.
Looking at you, buddy.
I'm pretty sure I didn't shoot him. Did I? Get a fucking grip, Lynch.
poor Lynch. Huh. He's got quite a collection of pills over here. They look awfully two-dimensional. Let's take a closer look. Zolta dots. Will make your wrist loose? What? Oh, Lynch. Swiffle dawes. This type of medicine requires lots and lots of small writing that you cannot see in-game. And they forgot a space right there. Oh, highly addictive and may cause bad stomach. Let's see. Viganozo will make your head spin if going beyond daily recommended use. Oh, Lynch. Well, at least he is medicating. Well, calm down, dude. Alright, so we gotta shoot another gnome before this hillbilly over here will kick out Lynch. Goodbye, mushroom eater. Alright. The way I see it, this is just revenge for Kane and Lynch 2. What ponytail? What are you talking about?
Cool down. Look, I know that wasn't me. Okay? So I suppose it was Santa Claus coming down his chimney, huh? You shut the hell up!
I suppose that was Santa Claus coming down a chimney, huh? Oh, poor Lynch. But we get the shotgun, and I think it's the only place you can get the shotgun in the level. And it's gonna help us out a little bit with beating Lily's challenge. I missed a box here. What? I'm not good at reading upside down. Waffle Boys, huh? I wonder what the Waffle Boys are. Kind of sounds like an Adult Swim thing, you know? Oh, Lynch. Cheer up. They'll make a Kane and Lynch 3 someday. I know. They'll make it someday. I promise. No, they're not going to make it. They're not going to make that game. Alright. Let's get back to the booth here.
So, did you win? My sweet Lily.
I'm gonna shoot you right in your smug fucking face. Oh, I'm sorry. Phew, that was close. Alright, let's try again. So, with the shotgun, we can get multiple hits. I don't think any other gun can do that. It does suffer when you shoot at range, though. But if you get a bullseye, you can get an additional 10 points or so. Of course, there we go. It is possible to get bullseyes at range with the shotgun. It's just pretty difficult. And I'm not sure what I was doing right here. God damn. So one thing to keep in mind about the shotgun is that the point shooting is very, very slow. It's slower than the shooting. So, yeah. Never, ever, ever use point shooting with a shotgun. I'll be showing off that Okay. The problem with the shotgun is that if you don't take your time to aim, you get, like, no points at all. It really sucks. And here I am trying to use the point shooting again. And then I make it worse by putting another shot in there. God, so slow. And they've already moved down. Jesus. Yeah, nice. Well, in case you haven't realized by now, I don't win this one either. At this point, I was contemplating whether or not to just shoot everyone down in a fit of rage and then take my guns back, but... God, I'm sweating like a pig right now. Like I said, Boston, Massachusetts, 98 degrees, no fan, no air conditioner, sweating my balls off. So, I finally decided to go with the Ultra Max here. I guess the easiest way to beat this challenge is to pick a gun with long range, good accuracy, and a very large clip. And that meets all those criteria. Alright, fireworks. Sweet. Makes me feel special.
Dang, you beat me fair and square.
Damn right I did, lady. With my fucking LMG. In case you're wondering, you get the same exact cutscene whether you beat Lily or you steal them, whatever. Alright, come to Papa. Yeah. Yeah, they feel good in your hands, don't they? Oh-ho, another dirty-ass letter from Birdie. Alright. Next up is, Mr. Texas Man, whatever the fuck his name is. Alright, so now that we've got our silver ballers, we can get out of this place. For good. Alright, the only thing left to do is to sneak out the door. Wrong door. There we go. Alright, so that was Birdie's gift. And it was quite a gift after all. And I still didn't get that technique upgrade. I'm not really sure why that is. Maybe I need to play at a higher difficulty or something? I don't know. And of course, there's a bunch of shit here to get. So, I'm Nick Meister, and this is Let's Play Hitman Absolution. I'll see you next time. Stay tuned for a little extra bit, I think. Yeah. Stay tuned for that.
Birdie, he took my silver ballers as payment for his services. Now he's giving them back. For some reason, he's reaching out. Can I trust him? or has his allegiance shifted towards more lucrative business partners. No matter. Before I go after Lenny, I will reclaim my weapons. I have been adrift for too long.